Well, welcome everyone. Thanks for joining us for this panel on DNSSEC. I'm going to make the assumption that we have a fairly knowledgeable audience here, and I won't go into too much detail in making a few introductory remarks. But let's just say that roughly almost 30 years after the invention of the DNS by Paul Mocakpetris, and after at least a dozen or so years of specifying and working and planning for DNSSEC, we actually have something being deployed and working today. So the panelists, I think, are just perfect for this. So as a lot of you know, of course, the DNS is essentially a distributed database consisting of maps to help you navigate the internet. When you want to go to a website, translating that web name into a string of numbers that can actually be found is accomplished through the DNS. And so having the inventor of the DNS on the panel, highly appropriate. Over the years, a number of different weaknesses have been pointed out in the DNS. One, most recently, the ability to essentially tamper with those maps and possibly redirect people with malicious intent was pointed out by Dan Kaminsky. So very appropriate to have Dan here on the panel. The underlying technology in DNSSEC that's going to help us secure all this is the tamper-proof properties of digital signatures. So having the co-inventor of public key cryptography, Whit Diffie, here on the panel with us is highly appropriate. And of course, recent announcements about the about .com and .net and other high-level domains being DNSSEC enabled, keys being generated, keys being used to make signatures, the public key infrastructure that's part of DNSSEC appearing, supported by ICANN, who's playing an important role in that. And of course, to that point, we have Rod Beckstrom, the CEO of ICANN here. So I couldn't